Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture on calculation of power in AC circuits and the functioning of electrodynamometer. So how do we calculate power in AC circuits? So in case of alternating currents, the instantaneous power varies continuously as the current and voltage goes through the cycle. So what is instantaneous power? It is given by the equation P is equal to VI. So all are represented in small letters. P, V, I are the instantaneous values of power, voltage and current respectively. So if both the current and voltage waves are sinusoidal, the current will be in lagging in phase by an angle of 5. So we should understand when small p, V, I are represented, it represents instantaneous values of power, voltage and current. So what do you mean by instantaneous values of power, voltage and current? It means you are calculating voltage, current or power to that particular instant. So when we calculate power, voltage and current on one particular instant, it is represented in small letters and the current will be lagging by a phase of 5. So V is given as Vm sin omega t and I is equal to Im sin omega t minus 5. So this phi angle is given because the current is lagging by a phase angle of phi and Vm and Im are the maximum values of voltage and current. Then P is equal to VI. So we know power is calculated by product of voltage and current. Since it is a AC circuit, we are taking the angle values. So P is equal to Vm Im sin omega t minus 5. So by replacing omega t by theta, we get P is equal to Vm Im sin theta minus 5. So we can write this instantaneous value like this. That is P is equal to Vi, where V is equal to Vm sin omega t and I is equal to Im sin omega t minus 5. So I am replacing omega t with theta, then I get P is equal to Vm Im sin theta into sin theta minus 5. So let say A is equal to theta, B is equal to theta minus 5. So it looks like an expression sin A into sin B. So what is sin A into sin B? It is nothing but sin B can be written as 1 by 2 cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. So by substituting this formula to this equation, I get P is equal to Vm Im by 2. So cos A minus B, what is cos A minus B? Cos theta minus of, this is B. So minus theta plus 5 minus cos theta plus theta minus 5. So which will give me P is equal to Vm Im by 2 cos this theta and theta gets cancelled. So cos 5 minus cos 2 theta minus 5. So this is the expression I get by using this trigonometrical function. So now how do we calculate the average power? So average power is calculated over a period of time. It is expressed as, it is defined as the time average of instantaneous power over one cycle. So average power I have to calculate over one cycle. So in that case, P average is given by 1 by t integral of 0 to t p of t dt. Okay, it varies with respect to time, so p of t dt. So we have already found out what is the instantaneous value of power. So Vm Im, it is constant, so I am taking out, divided by So this t value varies, a complete sine wave takes a time period of 0 to 2 pi. So Vm Im by 2 pi integral of 0 to 2 pi sine omega t into sine omega t minus pi dt. So this I can again write as Vm Im by 2 pi integral of 0 to 2 pi. So this looks like a function sine a minus b. So what is sine a minus b? It is nothing but sine a minus b is nothing but sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. So we know a is nothing but omega t and b is nothing but phi. So I can write sine omega t cos phi minus cos omega t sine phi. So now I am putting this equation in the place of this. So I get sine omega t into sine omega t cos phi minus cos omega t sine phi. So now I have to multiply. So P will be equal to, that is average power will be equal to Vm Im by 2 pi integral of 0 to 2 pi sine square omega t cos phi minus sine omega t cos omega t sine phi. So when I multiply with the sine omega t, I end up with this equation. So again, when I simplify the above equation, Vm Im by 2 pi. So here this cos omega t, cos phi is a constant because all the terms are integrated with respect to dt. So cos phi will become a constant. So I am taking cos phi out, integral of 0 to 2 pi sine square omega t. Minus, again sine phi is going to be a constant, so I'm taking sine phi out, integral of 0 to 2 pi sine omega t cos omega t dt. So what is sine square omega t? So sine square omega t is nothing but, we use this integral formula, this trigonometric sine square omega t is nothing but one minus cos 2 omega t by 2. And similarly, sine omega t cos omega t is nothing but, we cannot integrate as such, so I multiply and divide by 2, 2 sine omega t cos omega t by 2. So 2 sine omega t cos omega t is nothing but sine 2 omega t by. So apply these two integral formulas in this equation. So I get Vm Im by 2 pi cos phi 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 dt. So this is integration 0 to 2 pi minus sine phi integration of 0 to 2 pi sine 2 omega t by 2. So when we integrate this, we get the value Vm Im by 2 pi. So integration of this full term will give me pi. and minus sine phi. When I integrate sine 2 omega t by 2, I get the value 0. So P average is nothing but Vm Im by 2 pi cos phi by cos phi into pi. Into pi. So this pi and pi gets cancelled. So P average is equal to Vm Im cos phi by 2. So this is the average power that we get after solving the trigonometric equation. This is a very important equation. So average power in a wattmeter is nothing but Vm Im cos phi by 2. So next, coming to the working of dynamometer, electrodynamometer, wattmeter. So electrodynamometer has two coils and they are connected in different circuits for measuring power. So we can see the fixed coils or field coils are connected in series with the load to carry current in the circuit, and hence it is called as fixed coil. So we can see this is the fixed coil in the circuit. So this is the fixed coil and it is also called as field coil. The moving coil is connected across the voltage and carries current proportional to the voltage. So we can see the moving coil is the round one. So the moving coil is also called as pressure coil. Fixed coil is also called as field coil or current coil. The moving coil is connected across the voltage and it produces voltage proportional to the current. And apart from moving coil and fixed coil, we have a non-inductive resistance connected in series with the moving coil to limit the current. And this coil is called pressure coil or voltage coil. So next, coming to the fixed coil. So these coils carry current of the circuit. So we can see these current, two current coils carry current to the circuit. The reason is they are massive and it creates no problem in carrying in and out of the circuit. So they are fixed and they carry current in the circuit, and they are divided into two halves. So these current coils are wound with heavy wires. So as you can see, they are wound with heavy wires and they are standard laminated to carry heavy currents. So normally, in order to carry heavy currents, we use a standard conductor. So since this current coil carries heavy current, it is made up of standard conductors, and these standard conductors will avoid eddy current losses in the conductor. The fixed coils are designed to carry even about 100 amps. But normally it is used for 20 amps. For power measurements which involves high load current, it is better to use 5 amps wattmeter. For precision wattmeters, two halves of fixed coil are connected in series for basic measuring. So we can see these two halves of fixed coil are connected in series for basic measurement. And the shunt connections are not used because it will introduce errors. And next, coming to the moving coil. So this is the moving coil which you can see. So this moving coil is mounted on a pivoted spindle. So you can see a pivoted spindle here. So, and it is fixed to the current coils. So this pressure coil or voltage coil is fixed to the current coils, and we have a pivoted spindle attached to the moving coil. The spring control is used for movement. The use of pressure coil is, since the current in the moving coil is carried by the instrument springs, it limits to values which can be carried safely by springs without appreciable heating. So the main advantage of using this moving coil is, since it is controlled by the springs, even in excessive heating or appreciable heating, this moving coil does not get any damage. We have a series resistor and it is used so that it can limit the current in the circuit, and the current is limited to a small value of 100 milliamps. The fixed coils and moving coils are air cored, and the voltage rating of wattmeter is about 600 volts by the power equivalents of the voltage circuit. Since most power is absorbed by the resistance in series with the moving coil, considerable heat is generated. So this wattmeter is designed so that it can the voltage can be passed till 600 volts, and we have a series resistance so that it can limit the current, but the series resistance produces a considerable heat. So next, coming to the torque equation of wattmeter. So how can we calculate the torque equation of wattmeter? So before calculating the torque, we will see what is the working operation behind this wattmeter. So as shown in the diagram, this current from the source moves to the load through the current coil. So current from the source moves to the load through the current coil, and it produces flux around the current coil. And now we have a voltage coil in parallel to the load. So we can see a voltage coil in parallel to the load, and this will produce voltage, and because of this voltage again a flux is created. So because of these two flux, current, it makes the pointer to move for the deflection. So because of these two flux, torque is created, which makes the pointer to move on the scale. So the current coil produces current in the from the source, the current passes through the load through the current coil, and because of this current coil, flux is generated. Again, we have a voltage coil parallel to the load, which produces voltage, and flux is produced proportional to this voltage. And because of these two flux, a torque is generated, which makes the pointer to move along the scale. So the deflecting torque is given by TD proportional to VI cos phi. So deflecting torque is nothing but the power value VI cos phi. So we have a phi value because the current lags by an angle of phi. Now VI cos phi is nothing but power. So TD is proportional to power. Now coming to controlling torque. Controlling torque is directly proportional to the theta of the pointer. So we know deflecting torque will be always equal to controlling torque. By equating these two equations, we get theta is directly proportional to power. So this above contents are referred from the textbook AK Sahani, A Course in Electrical and Electronic Measurements and Instrumentation. Hope this lecture is helpful.